Goethe Institute, in collaboration with Siegel Books, brings to its patrons contemporary German language literature in English. This series of books has been edited by Naveen Kishore, founder of Siegel Books. Most of the book covers have been designed by Sanandini Banerjee. Goethe Institute Mumbai presents excerpts from some of the English translations in the form of short films. These books and many more are available in Goethe Institute's free digital e-library on LiHey.
I have to deliver the lecture at the University of Frankfurt. It's on poetics. It is an honor, I must say. I mean, that lectern has hosted writers like Bachmann, Theodore Adorno, and of all people, Heinrich Bohl. Did you know Bohl used to visit our house when I was growing up to meet my father, who was a critic and a translator, well respected in his day? You know, as soon as I confirmed the lecture, my mind was flooded with thoughts. How should I structure it? What should I focus on? The first thing I decided was that my lecture had to be free of anecdotes. I will not refer to my books and I will not refer to my plays. I will speak of other people's works. And to be honest though, I am the kind of person who is most likely to confess something about myself when I am speaking of someone else. And this was about Frankfurt. Frankfurt. There is so much that connects me to Frankfurt. My first trip to the city was well over 40 years ago. I remember I had a driving license, so I was definitely of age. But if you would have seen me, you would have said that I look like an overgrown boy, one who has been forced to put on long trousers and a jacket. That's how it was in those days. If you were going abroad, you had to wear a smart jacket and a tie. Never mind that abroad was only about 4 or 5 hours away. But when I moved to Frankfurt many years later, I had become a tad more of an adult. I had a wife and a job as an editor at a publishing house. I remained there for 17 years. Well, if we are counting, I should say I was there for about 10 books of prose and 6 plays. When I returned to Switzerland, I had mixed feelings. I felt like I was more of a German writer than a Swiss writer. But at the same time, I also thought, what is the big difference between someone from Frankfurt and someone from Basel? Same language, same culture. But with time I learned, they had different histories. You know, when one lives and suffers under fascism on a daily basis, it makes them different. I had not suffered it, yes, I saw it, through something like a fence. When I peered through it, I feared for my life, but I felt safe in the knowledge that I was not at its mercy. What really bothered me though was the way fascism devastated the German language. It used to be soft and beautiful, but those 12 years turned it into a one-dimensional linguistic dummy, full of hollow phrases. Every word was infected by the lies, the false realities of the dictatorship. And for us writers and poets, that corruption of language, it hurt. It really hurt. But it must have hurt the young writers even more than it hurt us, right? I mean, we had known the old language. But these young people, they had no memory of what the language had been like. Of course, they could sense how much their language had rotted. Fortunately, though, they knew no other. And unlike the generations before them, they didn't have a secure fund of language and thought at their disposal. These young post-1945 writers did not have any language. Every word proved to be sick. And the healthy words, they arrived on their own merits. But now, back to the speech.